What's going on, y'all? It is your boy, Joes McFly, and I know a lot of people have been asking me, some people have been asking me, for like a nice setup video. Woo! For like a nice video, talking about what's the setup that we have over here at John Boy Media, at the office. It's still ever evolving, you know, we have a lot of stuff going on, little by little. First and foremost, and I'm going to show you how prevalent it is in here. I want to thank Elgato for everything. Streaming and being in here and doing all this stuff has been so awesome because of you guys. So I want to definitely give you guys a shout out. But yeah, let's talk about the whole setup. Mostly, this is like what the stream station is and what we'll have here. The wire maintenance, don't worry about it. We're going to end up moving stuff. There's a new desk coming and stuff like that to make it look even better. But this is mostly to talk about some of the stuff that we use now. When we are recording podcasts in here, we're using this Rodecaster. Rodecaster's dope. It's great for podcasting. But if you are streaming and you're doing solo stuff, then this game, that GoXLR right here, is great. I love this GoXLR. It has a lot of sound effects and things like that. And to go with that, with headphones, I got my Astros A50, these wireless ones are dope, man. I love these. They're super comfortable, and they're great on sound, and they're great on comms and stuff like that. And even if you're just using them by yourself, it works perfectly. So I love these as well. Lighting is super important. So these Elgato lights, these key lights, are great. I love them in here. The great thing about them is that I can be able to control them using our Stream Deck, man. Yo, the Stream Deck is dope because I get to kind of, as I'm just streaming and things like that, I'm able to kind of like at arm's reach just be able to determine whether or not, you know, I want to put up the brightness or stream or play sounds. Or I love this Stream Deck. I actually can't imagine myself streaming without this, so it's great. We got the Stream Deck XL in here right now. This is the camera we have now. This is the Sony A6400. I think it's probably the best one, with the Sigma 16mm. These panels out here, love these panels. If it were up to me, and we're probably gonna end up doing it, I would love to panel out the whole room and then put out these the Elgato LED lights that they have, that you could also control using the Stream Deck. But it'll take a little bit of time. So, you know, for now, we just got these. It's kind of like decorative, and these are great. But eventually, once you put these up, then this will like soundproof the room and all of that. So that'll be dope. One thing that we use all the time in here is the Elgato green screen, bro. This thing, we mounted that up on the wall, on the ceiling, I mean. We're able to pull that down and be able to use it whenever we're doing like watch-ins, or if we're doing like video games and we're just gaming together, just kind of playing on the screen. I love that one. Definitely heavily recommend that one. I have that one at home as well, so because I have a home studio as well. But for the office, that's the one that we have here. That one is great. As of right now, we currently have 3 gaming systems. We just finished getting a Nintendo Wii. We got a PlayStation 5. And we got a Nintendo Switch right now. Probably going to be getting the new updated Nintendo Switch, the OLED version, pretty soon. But for now, we have that one, and some more stuff coming. But in order to be able to play all of that, and I like to do a lot of streaming as well, when we're doing streaming on GM Gaming, it's probably gonna have, you gotta have something to be able to capture it, capture the card. For my camera, I wouldn't be able to do it without the Elgato Cam Link. The 4K Cam Link is great. I believe this one is the Elgato Cam Link that we have here. We have this one for this camera. And to be able to do a game capture, if you have it, all right? If you don't have the space on your computer, because we have a computer here, we built out this computer with liquid cooling, a whole bunch of RAM, and I got a 3080 in here installed. We specifically did this and got this done. But if you can be able to get the 4K capture card from Elgato, the Elgato 4K capture card, that'll be great. It's super crisp. It captures in 4K, and it basically gives you the best image that you can for your gaming. So that's just, for me, I would heavily recommend it. If you don't have that, then you could actually go with my, I usually use this now on my my setup when I use it on the go, but this AC60S that I don't currently use anymore because I have it on the PC now, but I use this when I'm like on the go and stuff like that. But other than that, I would definitely recommend using the Elgato capture card, the 4K capture card, which is great. Last but not least, I mean, the last thing I'll talk about is, because I have a whole setup at home, but sometimes I'm on the go. Like if I'm gonna go visit family or if I'm gonna go stay over different people's houses, or if I'm gonna travel down, whether it's traveling down to Florida or if I go to Dominican Republic or anything like that, I do have a on the go kind of system that I have right now that works great. I use it to even podcast, and I also use it for me when I'm also going to be gaming as well, depending on what games I am. I am playing, because sometimes I'll take my Nintendo Switch and I'll stream that. But this is where I take my laptop. This laptop that I have here, it is a Razer, has a 3080 in it. And the great thing about it, I use this camera. Elgato has this new camera now, where it's like this this face cam that they have, which is dope. It's great. It's way better than the laptop cameras that you have now. I don't want to lug around my DSLR cameras or take them with me all the time. So that camera works great. I love that camera, the way that it works. And I usually take this with me as well. This, to be honest, is the best USB mic that I've used to this point. This mic right here works great. It's awesome. It allows you to mute it. You can be able to connect your microphone to it, and you can set your sound levels and your mixer levels right into, you know, it's all, once you install this, you can be able to use it right through their software. So it's great. I love using that. To capture the game on the road, gotta use this. HD60S. I have a 60S Plus at home. HD60S Plus. Have this one or the Plus work great for me. Capture the game. Especially when I'm on the go, or if I'm at a place where, you know, I don't have my whole setup, that one works great. And then of course I got my heavy duty laptop. I usually take my headphones with me. So I'll take those Astros headphones with me too. And I have the ability to use those headsets as my mic and stuff like that, but I still choose to take this and use this when I'm on the road or anything like that. Because it gives me such a great sound. So I just love it. I definitely recommend that when it comes to that. But other than that, man, this is basically the studio. Let us know if there's anything that you guys recommend, things that we should add. Obviously, we're gonna organize it. So please cut us some slack on the wire maintenance and all of that stuff. Please, please do that. You know, we got other stuff going on here. You know, there's another, like the other table where sometimes Jimmy and Jake sit and they'll have this. And they'll use these mics and they'll set up this table and stuff like that. But we'll see what happens with that. Everything's ever evolving, and I'm very excited to be spearheading this for the company with us. But definitely thanks to Elgato and, you know, all of the other people that that helped us as well. And let's go. But let us know what else we should add. I don't know what else we should add or what we should do or what we should change in here, but let us know.